I'm going to do pinwheels. With vegetables, I'm going to show you pinwheels. So we will see how the pinwheels are done and how it should be prepared in the proper way. I have cut the sandwich bread lengthwise, 2 pound sandwich bread. Then what you have to do is you have to just slightly roll it with the rolling pin so that you know certain places are thick and thin, so that that should be coming out nicely. I think I showed you some time back polka dotted pinwheels, something like that, but it's a little different now. I have got 4 things for y'all: mustard cream, potatoes boiled, squeezed through the string upper mold or mashed it, beetroot grated, boiled and grated, and squeeze out the juice. Carrot also boiled, grated and squeezed the juice. Now we have got 4 things. What I'm going to do now, with a little butter, first thing I will mix for this mustard and a little salt for this. Mix it and keep aside the potato and nicely mash it up. Salt, a bit of pepper, I need green coloring. I'm going to put a little green coloring. Let this be. We'll put a little more butter, salt and pepper. That's also done. Now, carrot. For these 2, we have to use salt, pepper. You have to use more of pepper, then only that will have the taste also. Right, this is also ready now. The first thing that I have to do, even when we make sandwiches, mustard cream, butter and a little salt we have to put first. Mustard cream, it will be really nice. Divide this into 3. Divide into 3. For both I will do together. Beetroot. Always beetroot should come in the center, not on the side. I'll do for this also and finish it off before we start putting the potatoes. Now this potato, I wanted to put a little cheese to make it more tastier. I'm putting a little cheese into it. Sometimes what I do is I put cheese, sometimes I used to use a little fish, boiled flaked fish or salmon into this potato paste only, this potato cream. Now I will roll this from the carrot side, from the carrot side. And it's getting pasted with the potato side. So, take an oil paper, keep it ready to roll this tight. Like a toffee. Toffee wrapping we call this. Wrap this. There will be 10 slices. You can have 10 slices done like this and leave it in the fridge. Leave it in the fridge and then whenever you want, you can cut and serve it. Generally, you could do like, you know, you can always make this pinwheel sandwich today and take it for tomorrow also. But normal sandwiches, if you do it in the morning, you have to cover with a wet cloth and keep it till you use it on the same day. We can't keep for the next day, but what you should do it, this pinwheel today, if I make, even day after tomorrow I can take it. What should I do? I keep it with the oil paper wrapping till I am going to use it. Before that, don't open it, right? For 2 days even I can keep. This is the trick of the pinwheel. Now we will see how we are going to do this. Tea time, we can serve this. Tea time. This is what I was thinking of doing for you. Then comes with the onion rings. Okay. This is the way you could have it if you want for dinner time. Pinwheels with the variety of preparations I have shown you, so that you can enjoy preparing this type of preparation, because this is something different to the normal way of cooking. I hope to see you next week with another episode very soon. See you. Till then, bye from me. See you soon.